Yep, unfortunately. It's coming to this rug now. Oh, not quite. Yeah, you guys are doing all right. Not too bad. Rosie's a little scary. She's almost done.
It just won't start. There's nothing wrong. There's no lights here indicating that the bin is full. The bin is closed. It's completely empty. The bag. I don't know. They say to take this. Move it about 8 feet away. And then, like, once it resets, it's supposed to, you unplug the base, and then once it resets, it's supposed to go back and empty, but it doesn't. Look at all this debris and dust that's just like not being vacuumed or sucked into the space. So I just press do the troubleshooting. Spoiler alert, nothing's gonna work. So now it's gonna reboot, but let me show you the other issue. The empty bin sensor. So, this is where the dust goes and debris. And so, when you empty the bin, oops, here. Let's check out where the dust sensors are. Idiots. So, at the front of the bin where the dust is being collected. This gets dusty. And now it's throwing a empty bin error. So you have to constantly clean these two sensors. Makes no sense that they're right there, and makes no sense whatsoever that you can't ignore these errors. This should be able to be emptied by itself. That's the whole reason why you would buy such an expensive product. Okay, so now you should be able to go home, and it should be able to clean or go back to the base. Let's turn this off. All right. Sucking up? Nope. Nothing. It's plugged in, lights on. $1,000 piece of junk.
I should have kept my video going because now I've taken all the hair out of the rollers and the sides, and this is what I got. So I pulled out both rollers. There's hair stuck around the wheel. I know golden retrievers are long-haired, but if you have a long-haired dog, expect this with this vacuum. So it's like you got to take it apart. See, there's a hair right here. You have to take it apart and pull the hair out. It doesn't seem to suck that hair up. And it looks like it actually looks like it wound that up so sharp that it destroyed the roller here. It's interesting. Just a thought if you're buying one of these. This is the hair amount from a golden retriever on these rollers I have to clean. Another thing right there. Dented that one too. Wow. Not too happy with that.
So there's Roomba, stuck again, just stopped for no good reason. Still have battery life. Says it's ready to vacuum, so let's send it home and see what happens. Says it's returning home. Yeah, that's not home.
This is what the Roomba i7 does with my dog here. A carpet. It does okay on the floor, but then I don't think it sucks it all the way in, and then this is where it ends up. Same.
Here it is again, trying to find its way home. After I sent it to vacuum, it went out in this little area right here and did not leave. And now it can't find its way back to its own dock. Again, even though it's right there, I can't find it. Even though it's a keep out area, it still likes to wedge itself in. Again, what's funny is it did this little tiny area right here. Even though I told it to go into the dining room and into the kitchen area and the entryway to vacuum it, this thing is just completely freaking lost. There's another don't go to area also. When it does, it gets wedged underneath, but of course that's where it headed to, which is bizarre to me. This is the Roomba i7. Well, did it? Does it see its home? Of course it probably does, but of course it's turning the opposite way you would ever expect. Yeah, again, it turns the opposite way you'd ever think you'd expect it. And do-si-do. Round and round we go. Where we stop, nobody knows. And that's been cleaned too, of course, underneath there, because I'm sure that's what the sensors are. So half its battery life will be used trying to find its base, which it's right in front of. And again, no clue. Humps it off the side, and it'll get hung up, and then have an error again, even though it's literally right in front of it. Why it's trying to back on is beyond me. So 5 minutes and it still hasn't been on the base. Round and round we go. Okay, can't get any tighter against the wall, but it's still trying to back up. Give it a little help, finally. Don't know why. It's a great vacuum if you want. This little spot done, and that. You know, it may or may not empty the bin, so 6.5 minutes roughly to do nothing.
Okay, I'm recording. I'm going to touch the button. As you can see, it turns on. Base station lights on. Nothing. It just sits there. It says it flashes clean with a white light ring around it. And that's it.